The Bible says, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. And that is what Betty Cornett of Cornett Ministries is doing. We'll talk about the work that she and her ministry are doing in Bulgaria. Betty Cornett is my guest today on Babbie's House. Stay tuned. It's coming up next.
Every day is filled with possibility. At Babbie's house, Babbie's house, everybody is family. Oh, welcome to Babbie's house.
Hello, everyone. I'm Babbie Mason, and this is Babbie's House. And I'm really happy today to have Betty Cornett, who is a very dear friend of mine. But besides being my friend, she is God's friend. And she is on a mission to take the gospel to Eastern Europe, to countries like Bulgaria. And she's here today to talk about one of her most recent trips. She spends a lot of months in Bulgaria preaching the gospel and helping children and helping women and building churches and building up the saints there and teaching the Bible and preaching the message of Jesus Christ in Bulgaria. We're going to talk with Betty Cornett. You're going to love this conversation. It's going to stir up your compassion and your passion for people. I hope you'll stay tuned. But right now, I want to sing a song for you, and it's called Shine the Light. Hopefully, this will encourage your heart to shine your light for Jesus.
Parking lot of the coffee shop just the other day. She smiled and she said, well, I'm doing okay, and I felt her pain. I took her hand in mine and said, it's gonna work out fine. But as she turned, I wondered, did I just hand her a line? What she needed most was a word of hope and a prayer or two, a little more time and a timely word could pull her through. And so I think of her and I wonder too, is anybody hurting sitting right there?
Let your light so shine. This is a room where an army vet put his life back together. A room where a family lived when their home was washed away in a flood. And where an elderly woman stayed while her husband recovered from a stroke. But it's more than just a room. It's a room like thousands of others at Volunteers of America, and a pathway to stronger communities. Because when lives are improved, communities are too. Through our programs and support, we work so that no one will be left behind. After all, who are we as a society if we don't help those who need it the most? To help strengthen your community, visit volunteersofamerica.org.
Real seniors, real concerns.
The economy is my concern.
Will we outlive our money?
Medication.
Rent is really more than some of us can afford.
You do without a lot.
And nobody comes to tell us what our rights are, what we can fight for.
If I get any kind of information that would help other seniors, I would let them know.
For information, contact the Senior Citizens League at 1-800-333-8725 or seniorsleague.org.
Making the world a better place is an intricate puzzle. And piece by piece, the women and men of Rotary have worked hard to fight hunger, promote literacy, and move the world toward peace. But there is still much to be done, still some missing pieces. And one of those missing pieces is you. Learn how you can help Rotary put together a better world at Rotary.org. Rotary, humanity in motion.
Oh, what a joy it is to bring the show to you today. One of my dearest friends is here as a guest on Babbie's House. Betty Cornett is a pastor's wife and co-pastors with her husband and has blessed churches and raised up children to minister in the gospel and raised up saints in the church to carry on the gospel. And the Lord has given Betty Cornett over the past 18 years to a passion to preach the gospel and to take the gospel to the uttermost parts of the earth. And one of those places is the country of Bulgaria. And Betty and her husband go to Bulgaria and they preach the gospel, they build churches, they lift up people, they teach children, and they're making a world of difference, shining the light in Bulgaria. Betty Cornett, thank you for being my guest on the show today, my dear.
Oh, you just don't know how happy I am to be with you.
Amen.
You are such a real person.
Well, thank you, Betty.
And so many people watch Babbie's House and are blessed.
Amen.
So many times.
Amen.
But ever since that I've known you, when you walk in the TV station, every time you are the same person.
Well, thank
you. You never change. You are that sweet, humble person that's being used of God. And some people just may not know that. I just want to brag about you today because you are doing a remarkable work with your Babbie's House. It's reaching far and wide.
Amen.
And it's touching people.
Amen.
Because you have such a variety of people on
Amen.
Here.
Amen. Such a variety of guests.
A variety, and it touches people.
Well, let me let you in on the inside, okay? Betty Cornett works here at WATC TV 57, where we record Babbie's House here in the Atlanta, Georgia area, and she does several TV shows here at the station and is just a great woman of God, a wonderful Bible study teacher, hosts several shows here at the network, and besides the work that she does here at TV 57 here in Atlanta, she takes the gospel literally around the world. Has been all over Europe, Asia with her husband, teaching and preaching, and bringing souls into the kingdom of Christ. And we want to talk about your trips to Bulgaria.
Yes.
And how the Lord led you into missions in the first place, because, you know, we often have this preconceived idea that missions are, it's just for certain people.
Right.
You know, preachers or teachers mm-hmm. or, you know, a certain denomination of people or even a certain race of people. I grew up thinking that, and just love me because you're supposed to love me. But I grew up a little black preacher's kid thinking that all missionaries were white people.
Mm-hmm.
They were single. They never got married. They never had kids. They went off to the uttermost places of the earth like, you know.
Monks.
Yeah, like monks.
Live like monks.
And nuns. and sacrificed their life to the natives.
Yes.
Never were heard of or seen ever again. And I thought that, well, that was for them, but that's not for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell you, there is no
condition to the Great Commission.
No.
I heard somebody say you're either a missionary or a mission project.
Yes.
And you are taking the gospel to the ends of the earth. Tell me about the work that you're doing there in Bulgaria.
Well, Babbie, at an early age, when I was just 10, 11, 12 years old, I was praying fervently because I felt like that God wanted me to do something at that early age. And at 13, I started playing in the church and never had music, you know. But I always, always was very, very concerned about people and about people being saved. And I was the baby of four children, and my daddy, we were just talking about this morning at the breakfast table, my husband and me. I said, you know, Daddy always said Betty's special. He'd tell people, she's special. She's not like the others. And so I did. I married a minister because I kept praying. I kept on my knees because nobody that I had dated even came up to even think about what I needed, you know, for my life. But I married a minister. He was a minister when we married. We immediately began to fast and pray. And Babbie, in our first year together, evangelizing and preaching, the Lord gave us a vision that we would go to other countries. We saw in a vision people with all kind of cultures and costumes and things. And we knew that God was going to take us to places that we had never known. I came from a little country town, and Tim came from a housing project in Savannah. God can use ordinary people to
do
extraordinary things.
If they step up and be obedient.
Just step up and be obedient. That's exactly right. So anyway, we have had already pastored three churches and had visited 86 countries preaching in Bible schools and just preaching the gospel, seeing people saved, and me singing, you know. And then around the 1980s, the latter part of 1980, our daughter Tina had gotten married, and the nest was empty, and we'd been waiting for that because I said I had purposed in our heart to go full-time and go and travel and see where God wanted us to make a difference. Now, at our age, we were getting on up there, and we just thought, you know, let's don't just go through a country and just be gone and never show up again. Let's go and make a difference. And so Bulgaria was that place that God placed in our hearts. We started there in 88. Before communism fell, we were doing underground services there. And so that went wonderful. We just had so many people saved. And so, and after the wall fell, you know, you could rent the theaters and the culture centers and the stadiums, and they were full. We'd have 4,000 or 5,000, and sometimes it was 10,000 or more. Now, in Bulgaria, that's a lot.
That's huge.
Now, when you talk about Africa and places like that, you can go into the hundreds of thousands. But you talk about a communist country that's so embedded in communism as Bulgaria. You take each soul, Babbie, very important.
Yes.
One soul there means
a lot.
It's a miracle. So, but that's where it was. It's been always hard. It's very difficult to serve there. But God just gave us favor because it was our assignment. And so we've stayed there. We started with a Bible college. We went from there. The students started going out to the villages. We had 11 churches in 2 weeks that we didn't even know about. And they were just going in the highways and hedges, compelling people to come to the least little houses, having prayer services. And so now we have over 40 churches, and we don't really know how many we have because a lot of our students have gone into other countries. We've got one in Brussels, we've got one in Germany and in Turkey. They're just everywhere.
Look at the Lord.
You know, and so we're just praying for God just to continue to send people out from the ministry there in Bulgaria. And so things are going really well. We've been there actually going on 25 years now.
25 years now.
And so when we were able to get up into the northeastern part is where our headquarters is, close to the Black Sea there. Romania is our northern neighbor. And we began to see what God was really wanting to start to focus on the children. And we found some property, and God showed me as we looked at that property, it had an in-ground pool that was just concrete, nothing there. God has changed it around. We have got a tent there for them to play games and to have as a cafeteria. We cook three meals a day there for them. A summer camp. We have 8 weeks in summer camp. We're teaching them the Word of God.
Oh, Praise God.
We're teaching them the awareness program, which is servicing now out everywhere, how to protect themselves. And from the camps, we have the ladies' conferences, the men's conferences, the marriage conferences. We have everything to serve the people there as best that we can. And we have the Christmas project every year for the children.
Yes, I know
children.
About the Christmas projects. And you and take so, shoes
yes,
and clothes and toys.
And everything. And so I always have a big goal that I can try to reach, you know, every year, more and more children. I have taken, as the Bible says, my stakes from the tent, and I have stretched them out.
Yes.
And the stable and the stakes are mm-hmm. wider than they've ever been.
Yes, you have expanded your borderies.
Oh, I really have. And just before I came back my last trip, I was carried to the second largest city, Varna, and I went there, and they want us to come there and start all the awareness program and teaching the children and having the camps there for them. So it's just unlimited what
we
can do.
I want to know how receptive they are to the gospel. You know, we often think that it's difficult or they're resistant. But in our travels in third world countries and in Europe and Asia and Africa mm-hmm. and France, mm-hmm. the people as a whole there might be a resistance there. But when you get people in a room and they see the love of God mm-hmm. and their hearts are tenderized by the Holy Spirit, they are so primed for the gospel. What's your experience in that area?
It's exactly the same, Babbie. We actually serve three nations there, the Bulgarian people and the Gypsy people and the Turkish people. There's three nations there, and they're all intertwined together since they've been there for a long, long time, because Turkey ruled Bulgaria for over 500 years. So you've got that element that's been there for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
But all of them are receptive to the gospel, especially the Gypsy and the Turkish people. There is where the children are neglected, forgotten, and fallen in the cracks, as we might say, not getting the education they need. And that's what I am really striving for now. We had over 500 saved in the last period of time that I was there.
Oh, my goodness.
That included some of the adults, but mostly that's teenagers and children. And there is where the revival is. True revival is breaking out there among the young people.
When we come back after this break, I want you to tell us some stories.
Okay.
I want you to put some names and some faces to the trip there in Bulgaria, so we'll know how to pray.
Okay.
Pray with you and for you. We're going to come back.
All right.
After this break, we're going to come back with more of Babbie's House and hear some more miraculous stories of what God is doing through Cornett Ministries in Bulgaria. Stay with me. After this break, we'll come back with more of Babbie's House.
Hi, I'm Alton Brown, and I used to have a goat. Where did my goat go? Well, it went to a family who really needed it, just like the heifer cow I used to have and the water buffalo, which was really too big for my place anyway. Now, why send livestock? Why not say tractors? Because giving an animal is like giving someone a small business. All that wool, the milk, the eggs turn into income for medicine, school, clothing, a better home, a sustainable livelihood. It even produces fertilizer for crops. And of course, it makes more livestock, because you know, animals make baby animals. That's what they do. The next thing you know, the family that you gave your gift to is passing on the gift of the animal's offspring to another family who does the same thing, and so on, until pretty soon you have helped to lift an entire community out of poverty, all with your gift to Heifer International. That is a recipe for lasting change.
Hi, I'm Teddy Bruschi.
And I'm Jerome Bettis. For years, we knocked heads on the football field every time the Pittsburgh Steelers
and New England Patriots played. But now we're teaming up
to help people all across America who are uninsured and struggling financially.
It's the Partnership for Prescription Assistance, and it's already helped more than 6 million Americans in need in all 50 states.
If you or someone you know needs help paying for medicine, call 1-888-4-PPA-NOW. Or visit our website at www.pparx.org to see if you may qualify.
It's a free service, a free phone call, and you can get your medicines for free too.
Winning the Super Bowl is a great feeling.
Winning three is even better. But so is helping millions of Americans who are uninsured and struggling.
Call the Partnership for Prescription Assistance toll-free number now. The PPA team is standing by to help.
Hey, you know I was just kidding about the three championships. Boy, if you have it.
I'm so glad you came back to the show because I don't want you to miss not one word of Betty Cornett's testimony. She's just recently back from Bulgaria, so we know that this is fresh. You know that when you visit a third world country, the Holy Spirit not only does a work in their life, but He does more work really in the person that goes. I can attest to that. Been all over Africa, South Africa, East Africa, West Africa, all in the Asian countries, all over Europe. And I tell you, whenever I go, I never come home the same. Mm-hmm. I'm changed for eternity. And that's why I feel like it's important for us to go, particularly as Americans, because we get kind of lulled into our comforts here in America. And as believers, we think that, you know, well, I got to have it. I got to have a big house. I got to have a nice car. I tell you, you get over there and you're just grateful to have a roof over your head.
Yes.
You're grateful to have 2 feet to walk on and a meal that you can sit down and enjoy with your family. I want you to tell us give us a story or two. Put a name or a face on some of the work that the Lord is doing through Cornett Ministries there in Bulgaria.
Okay. I'm just going to tell different kinds of stories. The first person that comes into my mind is a little girl I've been working with for a long, long time. She wants to come home with me so much, and she wants to come to America. She just hugs on me and, "Will you be my mother?" Because, see, her mother left her and went up into Germany as a prostitute, and she never sees her mother anymore. Her dad's remarried, and her stepmother doesn't love her. And so she is so sad and has no one to care. So she gets a lot of love, and now she has a really serious problem with her liver. They found cysts in her liver, and they went in, and they've tried to dissolve it, but now they gave her medication. Well, the problem is, Babbie, that I was asking them, "Do you have your medication?" And they said, "Well, we can't afford it now." And I said, "Well, you know, I thought they was going to say something that would be easy for me to just reach out and give them the money." They said, "$600 left." And I know that's close to $500. And I couldn't believe it. And I said, "Let me see the report." And so I got a copy of the report, took the child to a doctor that I know, and the doctor verified, yes, this is the medicine, and it is truly what it's supposed to be, and it is expensive. And she said, "We're gonna help her. We're gonna make a difference." And so I said, "Okay, tell me what I need to do." Had to carry her to another doctor. Some different connections we made. Praise God! Today I can say that she's got that medicine free now.
Oh, hallelujah!
Free. That was God.
Thank
that
you,
was
God.
All God.
Yes.
Absolutely, just an answer to
God.
Prayer.
That is a miracle.
Because you know, baby, when you go with your heart right and humble before God, He'll put favor before you every time.
Yes, He will. Yes, He will.
Then
you'll be able to make an eternal difference.
Yes, and another village where the kids came to camp this summer, and there were about 50 boys that were in that crowd, and that's a prominently Muslim village. That was very, very unusual, and I would say that that's another God thing for them to allow that many teenage boys, because Muslims will not allow those boys to go to a church or go anywhere, you know. About 50 of them were there. Well, anyway, then during the week, all of them were praying. They were giving their hearts to the Lord. Every day when we had our Bible study and gave an altar invitation, little by little, they were coming up every day. And so then we have baptism, see, on the last day. And the word got back to the cleric there in the village that the children were getting saved and were going to be baptized. Now, when he heard that word baptism, that really bothered him and made him very angry. And so he put out a threat to those boys, and he said, "If you get baptized, you will be beaten, and you will be beaten every day until you denounce Jesus Christ." And so the boys came to me and the teachers and told us about it. And I said, "Well, guys, you need to do what you feel like you want to do. We're not going to tell you you have to be baptized to be saved even, because you've received Jesus as your Lord and Savior. The Lord knows exactly your situation. I don't ever want to put you in danger. And so you just go according to what your heart tells you to do." They didn't even stop to think 1 minute. No, Miss Betty, we're going to be baptized.
Oh, my.
We're going to be baptized no matter how we will suffer. And so they were, and I've been back to the village there, and I checked on them, you know, and they said, we're having a really, really hard time of being persecuted, and they are really trying to annihilate us from the village. But he said, we're standing strong, and we have a church there in that village, so they're going to the church every week and gathering together. We're praying for them. That's a matter of prayer for all of our churches, because they all have that problem. Is, well, a lot of the Muslim children come to the camp. Isn't that a miracle that they allow them to come? Because I require a signature from the parents for the children to come, you know, so that they won't think that I've kidnapped them. And because I send the bus out there, you know, to pick them up, a big bus to get all of them.
Oh,
so we have a wonderful, wonderful camp, and it's making a difference in the lives of so many kids. We had
you
more this year than ever.
A phenomenal job there in Bulgaria. And let me just say something while I'm here. If you have ever wanted to put a name or a face to missions, if you ever wanted to pray for a country or pray for a missionary or pray for a work, you can do it today. You can put a name, Betty Cornett, Cornett Ministries. You can put a country, Bulgaria, Eastern Europe. You can put a mission on your heart and pray for this ministry and support this ministry, even with your finances. Can you give me a website so that people that are watching may contact you, may even want to contribute their prayers or even their finances to this work?
Thank you so much, Babbie, for allowing me to do this. And it's cornettministries.com, and there they can donate online. And we also, at any given time, they can sponsor children for the youth camp, or they can sponsor children for a Christmas project. Just whatever time of the year they may be watching this, there's always a project going on that they can support one of the children.
And now, let me just encourage you before we leave, as the book of Nehemiah says, stay up on the wall, Betty Cornett.
Yes.
Stay up on the wall, my friend, and don't come down. There's too much work to do.
Amen.
No time to turn around with a hammer in one hand and a weapon in the other.
Amen.
Stay up on the wall and don't come down. And that's my word for you today, too. Thank you for tuning in to Babbie's House. We love you. Our prayers are with you. We'll see you next time. Until then, may the Lord God bless you real good. Oh, praise God.